A very good evening to everyone. I'm Deepa Ganesh. Myself and Ms. Deepa Sanjeev are moderators of this event. On behalf of SAN Group of Schools, I welcome you all to this webinar. COVID-19 has been a demanding time for all of us. I sincerely appreciate this thoughtful idea of conducting webinars by our management and helping us stay motivated and engaged during these challenging times. Over to DS.
Thank you, DG. Good evening, everyone. On behalf of SAN Group of Schools, I welcome you all to this webinar. Today, we have a well-known Indian cricketer, Mr. Narayanan Jagdishan. He has completed his MBA degree from Ramakrishna College. He made his first-class debut for Tamil Nadu in the year 2016-17 and Ranjit debut in 2016, where he won the Man of the Match award. He made his 2020 debut for Tamil Nadu in 2016-17 season and Interstate 2020 tournament in 2017. He was backed by Chennai Super Kings in 2018. Sir, on behalf of SAN Group of Schools, once again, I welcome you to this webinar. Over to DG.
Thanks, Riyas. A hearty welcome to you, sir. Importance of sports is the topic we are going to hear from Mr. Jagdishan Narayan. In a country like India, with so much competition and limited infrastructure, choosing sports as a career is not generally encouraged, sometimes even considered risky. So let's hear it from the expert who managed to tread this challenging path and come out victorious. We have 40 minutes and the last 10 minutes will be for question and answer session. I request the audience to please jot down any questions you would like to ask our guests and post it in the chat at the end of the session. In the lines of Sharad Kamal and R. Ashwin, here comes our next Chennai sports star, Mr. Jagdishan Narayan. Over to you, sir.
Thank you so much for having me over here. And I'm really, you know, privileged to, you know, address this group of people. And, you know, and most importantly, I'd like to thank the SAN Academy because, and also given the topic is sports is career, something which I've been doing my whole life and which I've really enjoyed so much. I'm just really happy to talk with you guys about it. So to begin with, I'd like to just say by beginning with, you know, there have been days where, you know, sports have been just considered as hobby. At the moment, you've been seeing a lot of growth towards every sport. And, you know, nowadays people don't consider it as a hobby because people have started taking it up as a career. I mean, having sports as a career is something really, really special, and also it's a very exciting task because you get to experience a lot of stuff. Like, you know, you need to get outside your comfort zone. You can never be in your comfort zone when you are aspiring to become a big profile figure in your own sporting field. So, I mean, to begin with, I think each and every sportsman, every aspiring sportsman, I think it's very important that they really focus on what they need to do. You know, becoming a sportsman is different, and when you want to achieve something, thinking of becoming a sportsman is something different. For you to achieve what your goal is, I think it's very important that you have the proper grit, perseverance, and also immense discipline on what's happening around you. Because I personally feel it's not very easy for people to, you know, just get everything on a golden plate and just reach their goals. For you to reach the goals, I think it's very important that you work really hard and, you know, work towards it with a proper discipline. When I talk about discipline, it starts with the time you get up in the morning and also each and every meals that you have. And I think each and every thing that you do in your life matters a lot because that brings in a lot of discipline and also a lot of self-belief, I feel. There will be days where you just don't feel like getting up in the morning and you just don't feel like working out or, you know, going. For example, let's say that there will be days for so many people who just don't feel like going to school. But you have no other choice but to go to the school because you need to learn a lot of stuff at school. So that's the way even sports is played. There might be days where you just don't want to go to the field, but you'll have to push yourself to go to the field. That is something which I'll be and this is something about what hard work and immense discipline, what I was talking about. This is something we really need to focus on when you take sports as a career. And to be honest, you know, sports, it's it's been a bit of a risky path for a lot of people, because not everybody has been accepting that, you know, sports, taking up sports as a career has been the, you know, platter for everybody, because people have been a bit reluctant, hesitant, saying that, okay, when you're going to go inside sports, it's going to be a bit of a hard task and it's not a guarantee that you're going to become big. But I think the kind of effort and the hard work that you put in, every ounce of sweat put in, is something which really defines you, and that is something which really pushes you to achieve all your goals. 10 years back, I don't know, like 10, 15, 20 years back, if you had looked at sports, there wasn't a lot of, you know, progress in sports, because let's say that cricket was probably the only dominant sports which was, you know, telecasted and viewed by everybody, and everybody were really crazy about cricket. But nowadays, I don't think it's the same, because you see so many people, you know, choosing different sports, and, you know, and also every sport has just grown throughout the years, because you see so many people. I mean, cricket was dominant, but now I wouldn't say that cricket is dominant, because there are so many other sports which have actually gathered a lot of pace, and they're also coming up well. Sports like football, which we've got the ISL, and we've got Pro Kabaddi, which has become really, really famous. And we've also got badminton, which is probably the second most popular sport in India. So likewise, there are so many other sports. So many people are there into racing nowadays. So it's not that, you know, you have a one direction towards what you need to do, because there's been a lot of places where you can improve and also choose your career when it comes to sports, because nobody can force anybody to, you know, pick up a sport. I think it's very important that when you start sports as a career, it's very important to choose the right sport for you. Obviously, nobody's going to come and tell you this is the right sport for you. It's just the passion and the enjoyable moments that you get out of playing at school or something. Like, you just don't start playing every sport saying that it's my profession. No. I think it starts when you just start enjoying the sport. I mean, if you play like 5-6 sports, there will be a sport which you will enjoy a lot more than all the other sports. So, and your interest grows in that sport. So that is when you actually get to know that, yes, I'm interested in this sport, and I don't mind taking it as a profession. So once you take it up as a profession, there's no stepping back. When you have it in your head, I think it's very important that you work towards everything and work towards everything that you need to achieve. And you see a lot of people who are very passionate about sports, but you actually do not see a lot of people who actually play. And in that field, there are so many ways that you can also improve. You know, there are so many ancillary sports that are related to sports, such as, you know, having sports analysis, sports commentary, sports management, and there are so many other stuff. So obviously, according to me, playing the sport is something which is really special, and also everybody will want to do. I mean, playing sports, you learn a lot. And when you see that somebody is not, you know, as interested in playing a sport, but is very passionate about the sport, there are so many other fields where you can actually, you know, try and improve on it. You know, again, such as all the being a video analyst. You know, nowadays video analysts play a major role in every sport, because, you know, they collect all the data that are needed for a game, and, you know, they actually feed it to the players literally by telling them what you're going to come up against, and what you're going to face. At, for example, when I'm going to enter a cricket field, you know, before that we'll be having a meeting with all our video analysts and stuff, and you know, they actually come and literally tell you, okay, you're going to face such bowlers, and with the video help, you get to know what the bowler is going to come at you. You never know if he's going to bowl a bouncer or a short ball or something, because you don't know him. But because of the videos and the data analysis that you've got, it actually helps you and tells you which is the main thing that you really need to focus on, which is the best path the bowler can be able to do. It can be a Yorker, it can be a bouncer, it can be a good slower one. So these are the kinds of things, and there's some rapid growth in sports analysis. And also there are so many other stuff, such as being a sports lawyer, something every professional player has got a manager, and you know, when he goes into something, he needs to sign a contract. So it's always needed for a lawyer to stand by you and, you know, to explain you what's happening, because being a sportsman, you probably won't have a lot of idea about what's happening with the laws. But when you have the assistance of a lawyer, sports lawyer, he's always there to help you. He's always there to back you, because he knows what's happening around, and he's always there to correct you if something happens. Before you sign a contract, he's going to check it. And probably after contract, if you've got some issues with it, he's always there to help you and check on what's going to happen. So, and also, you know, there are so many other fields like sports manager, sports psychology, being a commentator for sports, you know, these are all people you see that are very, very, very passionate about the sport which they are into. So it's not basically that when you like a sport and when you're not able to play that sport, when you have no interest playing, but you're very passionate about the sport, there are so many other fields where you can also look to learn at. That is, that's something, and out of all these things, I think sports psychology is something which is just rapidly growing up, because I'm pretty sure everybody would have been seeing a lot of people, you know, having a lot of mental health issues and stuff, even when it comes to cricket or in a general life or something. So I think there's some rapid growth in that, and, you know, everybody have started training their mind. Before, I don't think it was of great importance that people had to, you know, train their mind before going into a game, or, you know, just preparing yourself for a game. So nowadays that plays a really big part in, you know, there's scope in so many other fields which are directly relatable to sports. So I think this is something really intriguing for me, and also something which I've learned over the years, because in the beginning I just thought, okay, I'm just going to play the game, and I had no idea about all these fields, because when I started cricket, I don't think having a video analyst in the team was also very important, because I didn't have any videos when I started. Only when we grow up, you get to see and you get to experience a lot, and only then you know the importance of what these fields are. This is something which I'd like to convey to you, because, you know, it's always good to, you know, put in your heads about all the different fields that are directly relatable to sports which you're passionate about. So I feel that is something very important to everybody to know what it is. And, you know, I don't know the specifics of, you know, what these are, but I just know the general topic, and I just wanted to address this to you people so that even you guys can know about it. Supposing if you find your passion in it, you can always, you know, pursue your dreams in that. So this is something which I really wanted to tell, and this was one of my main points. And one main thing, since everybody is in school right now, for me to, you know, put all these fields together and tell you what's relatable to sports and what kind of sports you need to get in, and, you know, it's totally your passion, grit, and, you know, ambition on any sports. But for all this to happen, there's something which I've actually learned very recently, that how important all these basic education is. I mean, the things that we learn in school is something which actually helps you grow as a cricketer. I mean, not a cricketer, as a sports person, because during school, obviously, I'm not very old, so I know what's been happening in school. And, you know, when I was back in school, I wasn't very eager to, you know, attend all the classes and stuff. You know, I wasn't very eager to attend all the math class, all the physics class and stuff, because we always felt it was, you know, we wanted to go play. We didn't want to sit in a classroom and learn. But something which I've learned over the years, and right now, I mean, in the past season, I've learned a bit more than that, because I've had a lot of detailed, you know, study on what's happening with that. And I've had a lot of talks with all experienced players as well. Something, let's say, I mean, since I'm into cricket, let me just talk about cricket. Let's say that I'm on a field and I'm playing a match. It's not that every time, I'm pretty sure you guys would have experienced all the international games where India's playing, and also all the IPL games where, let's say, Chennai Super Kings has been playing. You always have something called as the digital scoreboard. And it actually tells you everything, each and everything. It spoon feeds everything to you, you know, the runs required to win, the balls remaining, the equation between the balls and runs, and everything. When it comes to cricket, I'm pretty sure if we are going to start a cricketing career, it's not that you're going to play in front of all digital scoreboards and stuff. When you don't have all those digital scoreboards and stuff, there are so many other things which comes into play. Having the basic knowledge of math is something really important, because, you know, when you play a game, there will not be enough time for you to decide on what needs to be done. You'll have to be really proactive on thinking what you need to do. I mean, it comes right from calculations and stuff. You know, you'll have to be smart enough, and you'll have to be well aware of all the calculations that you need to put in while batting, because you'll have a lot of thoughts in your head while playing. But at the same time, you need to, you know, calculate everything. So I think all these basic education is something which actually helps you a lot. I mean, it's easier said than done, but still, when you're batting, when you all of a sudden you want to, you know how many runs required of how many balls in each ball, when you keep calculating, it's not something that's very easy, because there'll be a lot of pressure around you, and you actually need to, you know, handle all those pressure, and at the same time you need to calculate. And let's say that you become a captain of a team or something, you need to know the physical mechanism of what's happening. You know, there'll be a lot of strategies that you need to put in place of, such as, you know, there'll be a lot of wind factor in many grounds where you need to actually look at the wind, and, you know, you need to assess a lot of things that you actually haven't even thought of. That all happens when you actually enter a field, and, you know, it's very important for you to know what's happening around you, because that is something which will actually help you become a better player in your field. And at the same time, it will help you, you know, understand the game better. At the moment, I think no matter what sport you go into, I think it's very important that you understand what's happening in the game, because every time you understand the game more, much better than your peers, I think it's going to always give you one extra step. So that is something which I've learned over the years, and the importance of basic education that has been given in school. And sports in general, I'd like to talk a lot about this, because, you know, sports in general, I've experienced a lot, because right from the beginning, I've been part of the district team, and, you know, I've been part of the combined district team, I've been part of the state team and CSK and Ranji Trophy. So everything has been a progress for me. It's a process. Obviously, when you come into the sport, you play because you have fun playing the game, and you need to enjoy the game. Nobody can force you to say that, okay, this is your ambition, this is going to be the way you're going to make your life. No, nobody can tell you that, and it's not going to work that way. If you come into the field like that, there's always got a flip side, saying that it's not going to be the same way. Like, it's not going to be the way that you actually think of. Every time you play the game, I think it's very important that you enjoy the game. Each and every moment of your game, and each and every moment of your time on the ground has to be very enjoyable and memorable, and it has to be something you actually cherish. This is something which I truly believe in, and nobody can force you saying that, okay, sports, this is going to be your career. No, nobody can tell you that. I think it's just your choice, and it's your way of going into the sport. And when you go into a sport, I think it helps you so much, you know, it teaches you so much. I mean, there are so many stuffs that you learn inside a classroom. At the same time, I feel that playing a sport, you learn a lot more, because, you know, it teaches you so many things, strategies, something which you actually don't use when you're there inside a classroom, but you need to use a lot of strategies when you're out in the ground, saying, let's say football, basketball or cricket, anything. There'll be a lot of, the dimensions of the ground are not going to be the same. As I said, the wind factor is not going to be the same at every ground. So you need to have clear plans and strategies on what you need to do. I think these are some fields which will actually help you gain a lot more experience. And at the same time, you know, man management is something you actually learn when you go into sports, because you see so many different persons, and you see different characters. Not every character is going to be the same, where you can just tell them the same thing again and again, because few people will take it differently and few people will take it the other way around. So it's something which you learn by meeting a lot of people, and it's called man management, where you start handling people the way they like. And that also improves your captaincy skills and leadership skills, something which is very important in life. And more importantly, I think, especially when you get into a team sport, that is something which you really, really need to focus on, because everybody will be focused on their own individual goals without any doubt. But at the same time, when you're part of a team, it's always very important that you make sure that you're well connected with the team, and the kind of rapport you get the team together, getting the team together, and the rapport you have with your co-players and stuff. And I think the camaraderie that you need to have with all the players are something really important that not only teaches you, you know, in sports, but at the same time, let's say that somebody is not going to be in sports, but you need to, you know, go work in a corporate world or something. So even in a corporate world, you see a lot of, there'll be a manager and under him, you'll have a team of people. So I think when it comes to that, it helps people to, you know, again, have good man management skills. And at the same time, you know, let's say play for the team, because you can't be going your individual way, because you need to, you know, be with the team, and you'll have to make sure that you're happy in the team and others are also happy with you. So, you know, being in a team sport helps you a lot, improve as a sports person, and at the same time as a person that you're growing up into. And it also, I think, sports helps you, you know, help you a lot in decision making, because decision making is something which we always encounter it day in and day out, because we can't be dependent on people to make decisions for you. I think it's very important that you know what you're doing, and it all comes down to the decision that you take. So, I mean, let's say that when I'm in cricket, you know, when I'm batting or something, when a bowler is bowling at you, you know, you never know what speed is going to come at with you and stuff. But you really need to be focused enough, and you need to, you know, have that quick decision-making skill where you need to know that, okay, let me play a cover drive to home, or for me to hit a six, I need to make sure that my decision-making skills are very good, because not every ball can be hit for a six. It is very important at the same time to, you know, be defensive as well. Not every time is going to be a time where you're going to hit sixes, but at the same time, you need a lot of time to, you know, play carefully as well. These are all under decision-making skills, in which actually applies to you when it comes to normal life other than sports as well, because that is something which we see day in and day out. And something which I'd like to talk about is definitely handling pressure. And we've seen a lot of incidents that are taking place nowadays, you know, because something which a lot of people find it difficult to handle pressure. You know, pressure is something obviously everybody in life is going to endure it as you go up the ladder. But at the same time, you should also know how to, you know, handle all the pressure situations, because not every time someone's life is going to be of, you know, it's going to be a piece of cake. So it's very important that you know how you handle pressure. I mean, to elaborate more on how to handling pressure, it's simply that, let's say that you, again, it just comes down to decision making. I feel like when you're put against the wall and you're just made to do something which is very uncomfortable for you, that's when you actually need to be mentally strong. People talk about mental strength. I think mental strength is something which you need to train yourself. Nobody can come and help you, because, you know, as I said, getting up in the morning, let's say that you make a goal saying that you get up in the morning at 6 a.m. every day. You get up for 2-3 days, and the fifth day or the fourth day, you find it difficult to get up. So that time, it's always easier to say, saying that, okay, I've been doing this for the past 3 days. Now I'm tired. So let me just take a day off by sleeping or something. This is something what everybody can do. This is not something which is going to help you in a long run. It's easy to say that I'm not going to get up today, I'm going to get up tomorrow. But at the same time, when you do something which you don't wish to do, and you help yourself and you force yourself and motivate yourself to do something which you are not willing to do, is something which actually tests your mental skill and also your character, something which enhances your character and your strength, mental ability so much. I think that is very important for each and everyone. Never give excuses is something which I truly believe in. You know, there will be a lot of days where you make a lot of mistakes as well. But it's always easy to just give an excuse saying, no, it was not me, it was something happened. No, that is very easy to do. But it's very important that you know what you'll be doing, and at the same time, it's very important that you know what you've been up to. So I think the best part is, you know, not to give any excuses and, you know, try and endure what you've been doing always. And being in sports, the one thing which actually helps you become better in each and every point that I've actually told you is something which is in sports, you don't see a lot of good days. You see majority of your days being, you know, bad days. And then you do have a lot of good days, but I think bad days will be overshadowed by your good days, because, you know, let's take an example. I'm pretty sure everybody's aware of Mr. Sachin Tendulkar. And let's say that his batting average has been 48 after a career of 20 years, literally. We wouldn't always say that, you know, he's definitely the best in the sport. But at the same time, let's say the average is 48, and which means that he's been scoring 48 runs per game. That is the average. So even when you look into that, he's got 48% of good days, but he's got 52% of bad days. That's the way we look at it. So having a lot more bad days, you'll actually know how to handle pressure, your decision making, and the kind of maturity level that you get is something which is very good. And at the same time, it comes only when you play sports. And that's something which I really feel has to be done is, you know, being in school, there are so many people who are very interested in, you know, studying and stuff. But according to me, I feel sports is something you really need to focus on. And no matter if you have no interest or something, still you need to be into sports, because you experience so much stuff that you don't experience inside a classroom. Getting into sports has been something which has been really remarkable for me, and I've learned so much throughout the year, and my experience has been so good with it. You know, one small example is, you know, when I had a small conversation with Mr. Michael Hussey, I was asking him how all the Australian players prepare and stuff. In such incidents, I happened to ask him something about Shane Warne. He's been the greatest ever leg spinner to play. And so I was very intrigued about him, and I was asking him, you know, how good he is. So Hussey, all of a sudden, he comes and tells me, the day Shane Warne retired, Hussey went up to Shane Warne asking him, so how was your, I mean, it's been a long career for you, so what do you think of your career and how good has it been? Shane Warne's reply was, you know, my career, I think in percentage was, I think it's only 48 and 52, again, just like Sachin Tendulkar. So he said, Hussey, that, you know, being a cricketer, I've learned so much because I've had so many bad days. When it was my good day, I've never even thought of anything. But during all the bad days, I've learned so much. And that is the reason that I'm aware and the kind of mental strength I have. And after all the incidents that he's gone through, it is only because of that which has actually helped him achieve everything. So personally, after hearing to that thought, even I felt this was something which was really important for everybody's life. And I've always followed it. And, you know, since then, I've been putting in a lot of effort, and, you know, as I said, hard work and dedication is something which has been the prime focus for me, and I wish it is going to be the prime focus for you guys as well, so that you can make sure that your good days are a bit more than the bad days. That's something which I'd like to conclude with, and once again, thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your awesome and inspirational talk. I'm sure our audience would have learned and understood so many significant and important features of cricket. We thoroughly enjoyed your talk. Thank you, sir. Over to DG.
Thank you so much for having me.
Yeah, thanks a ton, sir. Yes, it was stupendous, your presentation. Sport is one area where one has to be innovative, think on your feet. Yes, grit is all that matters, passion with perseverance. Kids, that will take you to great heights. Thank you once again, sir. You have got a lot of fans, and I'm just starting with the first question. The questions have just poured in. Okay, how did you feel in your first match? Did you play with confidence? This is by Priya.
I mean, yes, obviously, you know, first match in IPL or Ranji Trophy, which match is it? So, I've never been part of an IPL game till now, but when it comes to Ranji Trophy, yes, you know, you've actually been working of the Ranji Trophy team for so long. So when you get your opportunity, I think it's the best thing you can do is express yourself and, you know, play with utmost confidence. That's what I did.
Cool. Thank you, sir. Over to DS.
Yeah, your next question, sir. How was your feel? I mean, how did you feel when you got selected for IPL, which was the same team as Atale, Mr. Dhoni?
I mean, obviously, it was a very, very special feeling for me, you know. Being a guy from Tamil Nadu, even I was really, really excited. And I've been a big fan of CSK, watching MS Dhoni and stuff. So, once they banged me, I think I was really happy and literally jumping on my bed. And yes, the experience for me has been tremendous. And being a wicketkeeper batsman, I've been able to, you know, have a lot of conversations with Mr. Dhoni. And he's been helping me a lot with batting and wicketkeeping.
Thank you, sir.
Cool. Thank you. Yeah. Yeah, sir. Your next question is, give some tips about TNCA selection. This is from Abhijit.
Tips about TNCA selection. I think being a cricketer, you need to really focus on how you improve and how you score your runs. I think selection is just a process. You need to put in the hard work, and selection is something you need not worry about. When you do well, you get selected.
Okay.
Thank you, sir. And before your next question, there are two great fans of yours from the audience who have posted that we are a great fan of you. So I would say their name, Renuka and Priya. So they have posted that we just love you and we are great fan of you. So I just wanted to convey that.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Renuka.
Your next question, sir. Who is your inspiration in the field of sports?
I mean, there are so many inspirations in cricket right now. I think I admire Virat Kohli a lot simply because of the way he plays the game. So aggressive and the kind of intent he shows, the hunger to win games for our country.
Right. Okay. Cool. Okay. Thank you, sir. Next question is, why did you choose cricket from GB? Why not other games? Why cricket? Yeah.
You know, I've been actually playing a lot of sport, but I got into cricket because my father himself was a cricketer. So he was the one who actually put me in an academy. So yes, when I started the game, it wasn't a profession for me. But once I got selected for district and state, then I took it seriously and became a profession for me. But I was playing a lot of sports. Like I said, everybody will play a lot of sport, but you don't choose everything as a profession. You choose which you enjoy the most.
Absolutely. Thanks for that, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, over to DS. Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you, DG. Your next question, sir. Have you met Virat Kohli in person? If yes, how was your experience?
I have, actually. Last year, I'm pretty sure everybody remembers the first match against RCB where it was a low-scoring thriller last year, IPL first game. So before the match, I had the opportunity to, you know, have a good long conversation with Virat Kohli. And, you know, I was just talking to him about how he prepares before a game. You know, there are so many insights that he's actually given me and something which actually I've tried. And since you've been asking me this question, let me just share a small experience to it. Saying that, when I went and approached Virat Kohli saying, can you just tell me the way you prepare for a game? He was like, can you tell me how you prepare before a game? So I told Virat saying that, before every game, I know who the bowlers are going to be against me. So I do a bit of visualization and I try to prepare. And he asked me one simple question, when do you do it? I told him one day before the game. And his reply was, yes, I do the same thing as you do. But the only difference is I do it 1 week before. So that was the kind of preparation and he was just being proactive.
Okay, cool, cool. Thanks for that, sir. Yeah, questions are just pouring in. I mean, like, some kids want to know how to convince parents. So when you told your interest about cricket, what was your parents' reaction, and how give us some tips to convince your parents?
Tips to convince your parents. I think, again, like I said, like few years back, it was an hindrance for you guys. But right now, I think most of the parents are very supportive when it comes to sports. But at the same time, I was very lucky right from the beginning. You know, my dad being an athlete himself and mom into a lot of sports, they have actually groomed me become a better sportsman. And they always were more excited seeing me as a sportsman rather than being someone who's been, you know, a topper in academics. So I've been lucky in that way.
Okay.
I don't know how to convince your parents, but I think you need.
I guess they will take tips from you now, and I'll understand how to convince their parents. So that was yeah. Next question that's for you is, who was your favorite cricket player during your childhood?
I've always admired watching Ricky Ponting. He's been one of the best batsmen ever. Even now, he's the best without
any doubt. Okay, that was cool. Okay, sir. So, especially when you shine the ball with saliva, how do you think COVID is going to affect cricket in the future?
You know, I strongly feel that shining the ball is a very major part in cricket. And I think the bowlers are going to get very affected. And the batsmen, you know, being a batsman sport, I mean, batsmen are more, it's easier for the batsmen. I think it's going to become really difficult for the bowlers.
Okay. Next question is from our audience. Her name is Sangeeta Ravi. And she would like to ask you, her son is in senior KG. Okay, he's studying in kindergarten. So she wants to ask you how to engage him now so that he gets interest in cricket.
I honestly feel you can't force someone to, you know, get interest playing cricket. It has to come from within, I feel.
Yeah.
Like, obviously, they play a lot of sport. Like I said, again, going to the first question, they play a lot of sport, but there's something which we can't just force people to, you know, start enjoying. They need to enjoy themselves.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Cool. Okay. Again and again, children are asking about more tips to aspirant cricketers. How to become a successful cricketer like you? I mean, they're really interested and curious to know that.
I mean, I think it's very important that you find a good coach first and foremost who teaches you the right technique. And at the same time, like I said, it's very important that you put in the hard work, which really matters. I think you need to keep working all the time, and, you know, without giving any excuses. And, you know, you should be very dedicated towards what you're doing.
Right. Thank you, sir. Next question is from a budding cricketer. His name is Sahil. He wants to know a tip for playing good cricket as he's playing for the Chengalpet team.
Tip for you to become a better cricketer. I think it's the simple way to say is just watch the ball and play. But, you know, but I think it's very, again, like I said, you need to understand how the game works. Not every game is going to be the same way. So every time you go out to the field, it's very important that you prepare before a game. You can't just go inside the field and then decide. You need to be proactive by preparing how you're going to go about the game.
Right, sir.
Okay. Yeah, thanks, sir. Thanks, Riyas. Yes, sir. So how does it feel to be a star at a very young age?
I mean, honestly speaking, I don't think I'm a star yet.
That's very humble. But, okay.
No, that's the truth, I feel. But yeah, being part of the IPL team and the Ranji Trophy team has been something really special. And I've been very fortunate enough to, you know, share the dressing room with a lot of international cricketers and legends of the game. So that has helped me grow as a cricketer and also as a person. I've been very fortunate.
Thank you, sir. Your next question, sir. Can you start a YouTube channel for cricket? That's from Anita PR. She wants to know if you can start a YouTube channel for cricket.
Something which I never even thought about. Since you've given me the idea, probably I'll just think about it.
Why not? Yes, sir.
That's cool. Thank you, sir. Okay. Your next question would be on, share your experience being with Dhoni. Tell her Dhoni. So, I mean, we are all eager to hear more. about that.
I'm sure everybody's eager to know this. Yeah, you know, sharing the dressing room with MS Dhoni, I was really excited. I'm a big fan of MS Dhoni, and you know, me being a wicketkeeper batsman, it's been very, very fruitful for me, because you know, I've always been able to go and ask him all sorts of tips being a wicketkeeper, you know, how to improve on my movements, how to improve on my gathering. At the same time, you see MS Dhoni finishing so many games for India, CSK, and so many teams. So, I've also been very fortunate in that way, where I can actually go, where I have actually went and asked him, you know, how to improve as a cricketer, how to finish off games, because winning the game is something which really matters. So, I've asked a lot of questions to him, and he's always been very humble to answer everything.
Wow, that's great.
Wow, that's nice. Thank you, sir. Your next question is, how did you manage academics and cricket?
I wasn't the best in academics, to be honest. But at the same time, yes, I was a very average student. But at the same time, it was something which my mom and dad put it for me right from the beginning, saying that, yes, your first preference is going to be sports. But at the same time, there's no way you're going to neglect studies. Your basic education is something you really need to focus on no matter what. Being a sportsman, yes, it's difficult to focus on academics. But there's no other way, but you have to find time to get it, be decent in it at least.
Oh, so time okay. Management. You just followed that. Yes, thank you, sir, DG. Oh,
okay. Yeah, thank you. Thanks, sir, for answering us patiently. Can we go on with a few more questions?
Of course, sure.
Super good. Thank you so much. Okay. So, TNPL is a good initiative. What else can be done to take cricket to nook and corner of India like it is in Australia?
I mean, I think, yes, in Australia, you see a lot of cricket being played. But at the same time, when it comes to Tamil Nadu, I think when you compare it with other states in India, I think Tamil Nadu has probably got the best facilities and, you know, the kind of league matches and the steps they've got to, you know, enhance as a cricketer for each and every person. So, TNPL has been one of the major stepping stones for all the youngsters right now. And for us to improve and becoming very good in cricket and taking it to nook and corner is something which I feel personally is, you know, put in a lot of scouts saying that TNPL is the basic step, I feel. And League Cricket of Chennai is the basic step. But for people to go into that, I feel, you know, there'll have to be a lot of scouts who go to other districts, moreover, not than Chennai. I think it's very important people go to districts. Because you tend to just leave out a lot of players who have the capacity and the talent, but they just don't come up. I think it's very important to have a group of scouts who actually travel the districts, go in search of players, and when they feel that they're special, they can always, you know, put them in a camp in Chennai and then groom them as a cricketer. That is something which will actually help us, I feel.
Wow. Awesome. Okay.
Yeah. Your next question, sir. How are you managing to practice during this pandemic, this lockdown period? How are you practicing during this period?
Yes, it's been very difficult at the moment, but again, I'm really fortunate in this result. I've got a net in my terrace, so I do a lot of batting and wicket keeping over there. Yeah, but and also, you know, gym. But it's been very difficult, and I see a lot of players who've just gone back to the basics by playing, you know, tennis ball cricket inside home, like how we all started. So again, it's a circle, I feel. People who went up are coming down back to the beginning, what they did and how they started. So, it's a good experience altogether as well.
Right. Okay,
cool. Thank you, sir. Okay, I think I will just wind off with the last few questions. A lot of female fans here. So, we need a mixed gender team in cricket, like the mixed doubles in tennis. I hope you agree. Is there any talks on these lines in the cricket management circle?
I don't know if there are any talks going on between how to have a mixed gender cricket matches, but I'm pretty sure we are going to see a lot of mixed gender matches as well, because recently we saw something that happened in Australia where, you know, a lot of Australian women cricketers were part of it, and also a lot of men cricketers were part of it. So when it's already been started, I'm pretty sure going into the future, we're going to see a lot of mixed gender, just like tennis.
Awesome. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Your next question, few tips on handling nervousness. This is posted by Karthik. He wants to know how to handle nervousness.
Okay. Very interesting question, but at the same time, again, it's just very easier said than done. But it's very important that you know, it's first and foremost, you need to be put in a lot of nervous situations. Only then you learn how to come out of it. First time, you can't expect yourself to, you know, not be nervous being in a situation. You learn from it. Of course, you're going to be very nervous at the beginning, but as time goes by and you experience a lot of situations like that, you learn and you automatically come out of it.
Right, sir.
Okay, that was great. Okay, sir. Your next question is, a lot of 10th and 12th graders are eager to know. They need guidance for 10th and 12th who practice cricket.
I mean, I don't know how I can guide you, but I'll just tell you my personal experience, how I handled 10th and 12th. When I was in my 10th, I never stopped cricket. I kept playing cricket. It was only 1 month before the board exams, I just stopped cricket. And as soon as the board exams got over, exam got over at around 12:30, 3 o'clock, I was there in the nets. You know, it was just a short 1.5 months or 2 months break for me. So that has been the way I've handled.
Oh, thank you, sir.
That was great.
Your next question, sir. When you play your first rounds, how happy, worried, or excited you are? This is posted by Nirmala Manikandan. When you play your first round, when you play your first round, how happy, excited, or worried you are? I mean, what kind of feeling do you undergo while you're playing your first rounds?
I mean, obviously, I'm not very worried at all. You know, I'm obviously very thrilled and excited to always, you know, start. That is something you've actually been working throughout your life, and there's no point in you going inside and, you know, when you start worrying about something, you just need to be very excited, like how you play each and every time.
Wonderful. That's nice, sir. DG?
All right. Excellent, excellent. Thank you so much, sir. Any more questions, DS? Anything else?
It got posted.
Yeah?
I want to know your story of your victory or success mantra, something that you would like to share, your success mantra so far.
I think, again, it just comes down to dedication and at most hard work and discipline. I think that's probably the mantra. And also, there's one motto which I've always been looking up to, and that has always been good for me, I feel. You know, it's something called as the work until your idols become your rivals. That's something been very, you know, the first time I saw it, it was really motivating for me, and I've always tried to do that.
Very inspiring.
Excellent.
Very inspiring, sir.
Yeah.
And we have one more. How is repeatedly people are asking this. They want to know your first experience in IPL. How did you feel?
I mean, obviously, like each and every youngster out there, I was the same youngster like you, was very excited to be inside the dugout of an IPL team. And, you know, it was such a very special feeling for me. At the same time, yes, I was a bit scared because, you know, all of a sudden when you go and sit inside the dugout, especially with a team like CSK, to your right you see MS Dhoni, to your left you see Suresh Raina and so many big players. You see literally the legends of the game. It's very scary at the beginning. As time went by, I got to know them. You know, I got to know how jovial they were, and it was a very good learning curve. And, you know, although I haven't played any matches yet, it has always been one of the best learning curves for me because you get to learn from the best.
Wow. Actually posted by Mithilesh, and he says he's a great fan of yours. So he wanted us to convey that also.
Thank you so much.
And we have one more question. How do you mingle with other players?
How do you mingle? I mean, again, being in team sport, there's no way that you can be idle. When you're there in the team sport, I think it's very important that you express yourself to other people. You cannot be, yes, there are a few people who are, you know, sort of an introvert. But at the same time, when you don't talk with other people, you never know what they are planning for you or how you're going to go as a team and have the same rapport. I think it's very important that you make a conscious effort to go talk with people.
Right. That was really nice.
Super good. Okay.
We have one.
Shall we just close with one last question?
Yeah, one we have already got. Do you play with confidence? That's posted by Priya. Do you play with confidence?
Yes, obviously, yes.
Yes. I think that is... Yes, sir.
Yeah, when you say confidence, I think every time you step onto the field, you need to have the confidence saying, okay, thinking that you're the best over there. There can be a bigger player than you. I mean, in stature wise, there can be a bigger player. But you can never put yourself down saying that, okay, he's a big player, I'm not. No, even I'm confident and I'm as good as him. So I'm here to face him. So I think confidence is something you need to have, not only in cricket, in everything.
Everywhere. Right.
Absolutely.
Yeah, DG.
Okay. So, someone is asking about Vijay Shankar and the IPL trails. I don't really get that. If you get that question, you can go ahead and answer.
I mean, I've never been part of the same IPL team with Vijay Shankar, but we play for the same league team and stuff. So, yes, okay. We've played a lot of cricket together, played for Ranji Trophy and stuff. And obviously, he was there in the World Cup squad and he's been probably the best all-rounder for Tamil Nadu cricket and very nice lad.
Okay, cool.
So, yeah, really nice of you, sir. I guess you have answered all of them so well and it was a pleasure to hear you. Over to Vijay.
Yeah, absolutely, sir. We are just delighted to have you on the show. Just great, your patience and it was really enjoyable spending the time with you. I think the questions have... Oh, sure. Anytime, sir. I think the questions are almost over. Okay. I am just moving on with a vote of thanks. Thanks a ton, sir. I'm just moving on with a vote of thanks. Yeah. I take this opportunity to thank our inspirational chief guest, Mr. Jagdish Narayan, who in spite of his busy schedule has accepted our invite and made this event special. Our beloved managing director, Ms. Archana, who gave us this wonderful opportunity, our admirable principal, Ms. Sujata Saravanan, our fellow staff members, and all our marvelous and supporting parents and students for spending your valuable time in this webinar and making it a big success. Thank you so much. Catch you next week with another interesting guest. Have a great weekend. Thanks a ton.